Hi there, and welcome to episode 3 of Birding with Dee. I'm Dee Fairbanks Simpson, and today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about bird beaks. It's important to understand bird beaks because once you understand the beak, you understand what the bird eats, and once you understand what the bird eats, it's going to be a lot easier to find them in the wild. So, the first thing I want to talk about is, have you ever been out in the wilderness, and you come across a barbed wire fence, and you notice that on the barbs on the barbed wire fence, you've got all these creepy insects impaled on the barbs, and there's sometimes critters and other things impaled on all the barbs. And you say to yourself, what on earth kind of sicko does this kind of thing? Well, if you keep watching this video, you're going to find out exactly what kind of sicko does that. But first, let's start off with birds that we call generalists. For example, this is a mockingbird. And the mockingbird is a generalist. He's got a medium-sized beak. He's famous for eating things like fruits and nuts and berries, and he can eat pretty much anything because he's an omnivore. Another type of generalist is called the blue jay. You're probably familiar with him. Now, the blue jay, in addition to eating all the same foods that the mockingbird eats, will sometimes also eat eggs, and sometimes he'll even eat the babies of other birds. Ah, help me, help me! Bad blue jay. Okay. Another kind of generalist is some of the woodpecker family. So for example, here we have the red-bellied woodpecker. And in addition to insects and fruits and berries, you'll also see them using their beak to drill holes on, well, in this case, it's going to be a Kleenex box, but usually it's on trees. And another kind of woodpecker that you see out there is called the yellow-bellied sapsucker. And they actually drill a very special kind of hole. It's kind of neat when you see it. If you see a tree like this, can you see the black dots that are drilled all the way around my Kleenex box here? That means that a yellow-bellied sapsucker has been here. And you know that because they always drill these concentric circles all the way around whatever they're drilling. So if you see a tree that has these concentric circles all around it, you know that a yellow-bellied sapsucker has been there. Okay, some birds are called tactile feeders. Now these are kind of cool because that means that they use their beak and they go out in the water and they go out and they use their beak to find food. So for example, we all know him. This is the roseate spoonbill. And what he does is he goes out in the water and he moves that beak side to side to feel around for fish in the water. Another kind of tactile feeder is this is a glossy ibis. And what the glossy ibis does, you'll often see him digging around like in grass. In this case, he's searching my hair for nits. But in the wild, you'll actually see them digging through grass looking for bugs and things. And that's called a tactile feeder because they use their beak to actually find things in the grass and in the grass or in the sand, wherever the bird happens to be. Or as I showed you with the roseate spoonbill, in the water. Now, there are other birds who are exclusively seed eaters. Now with a seed eater, you can tell because they have that big chunky bill. You know what I think? I think it would be much easier if we had a song to sing about birds with beaks and food. Luckily for you, I wrote one. Now just remember, I'm a terrible singer, so make sure that you turn on the closed captioning so you can sing along with me. So without further ado, bird beaks, bird beaks, bird beaks, bird beaks tell you how birdies chow. Sparrow and all their kin, finches just as Darwin, all eat seeds to suit their needs. Tactile feeders, tactile feeders, search for treats with their beaks, feeling through water and digging through the beach sand to fill their tum with critters, yum. Hawks and owls, hawks and owls, all eat meat with their beaks. Also known as raptors, real good critter trappers, they carry meat with talon feet. Look at the big talons on these birds. They have these big, big feet, and that's why they carry meat. Let's see if they can carry it. Yeah! Boom! Ahem. Now, where were we? Oh, yes, we were at the herons. Bird beaks, bird beaks, bird beaks, bird beaks tell you how birdies chow. Heron beaks are stabby, so they can eat crabbies and fishy fins. They're long and thin. OK, Okay, enough of this nonsense. Okay, so remember at the start of this video, I promised to show you what kind of sicko would impale stuff on barbed wire fences? Let me introduce you to the Northern Shrike! Ah! Also known as the Butcher Bird. So he catches prey, and then for a few reasons, including food storage and impressing girls, he totally goes all Vlad the Impaler on his prey. The shrike is one of the few known predatory songbirds, and in addition to insects, he'll also eat small mammals and other birds. Well, this wraps up this episode of Birding with Dee. If you have a topic or question you want to see in a future episode of Birding with Dee, please leave a comment here. Thanks for watching, and thanks to our sponsor, Birding with David Simpson. Remember to go to birdingwithdavidsimpson.com for all of your bird guiding, bird education, and bird consulting needs.